Can you name the items required for potting a plant? Yes. We require an earthen pot, soil, water, and plant to be potted. Can plants grow without soil? Most of the plants require soil. Why is soil important for us? If you see food chains around you, for example, plants eaten by deer, deer eaten by tiger, algae eaten by fish, fish eaten by storks or humans, algae eaten by small fish, or small fish eaten by big fish, or big fish eaten by crocodile. Plants also eaten by humans. We all, herbivores, carnivores, and omnivores, directly or indirectly depend on plants for food. Most of the plants require soil to grow, though there are some plants like algae, water hyacinth, which can grow without soil. Let's study about this soil. Soil is a natural resource which is found as the upper layer of Earth's surface. It also contains inorganic matter, organic matter, minerals, gases, and water. The soil is formed from rocks. Heat, rain, and wind convert the rocks into soil. What is the importance of soil structure? The fertility of soil depends on soil structure. Good soil structure helps in proper growth of plants. Roots get sufficient supply of oxygen. Water drainage is good, hence roots of plants grow well, which helps us in giving good yield. Let's observe soil. If you observe soil, you will see that it contains particles of various sizes. The structure of the soil depends on the different shapes of the particle in it. When the proportion of sand or large particles is more, it is called sandy soil. Water drains through sandy soil easily, so sandy soil cannot hold water. As it cannot hold water, it cannot supply nutrients. Nutrients which are necessary for the plants are dissolved in water and absorbed by roots, so sandy soil is less fertile. It is made up of mineral silicon dioxide. It is easy to plow this soil. Second type of soil is silt soil. The particles of silt soil are smaller than the sandy soil but bigger than the clay soil. So, particles of silt soil are of medium size. It also contains a lot of organic materials like leaves, dead matter, and some microorganisms. It can hold more water than sandy soil, but its water holding capacity is less than that of clay soil. It can supply more nutrients than sandy soil. It is not as easy to plow silt soil as sandy soil. This is also called sedimentary soil. Third type of soil is clay soil. In this type of soil, the particles are small. The proportion of these small particles is more in clay soil. It is smooth to touch. Clay soil has the highest water holding capacity as compared to sandy soil and silt soil. Hence, can supply more nutrients to the plants. It is difficult to plow clay soil. Now, collect soil from different places. Observe its color. We observe soil has different colors like black, red, copper, yellow, and gray. This is because of various ingredients which give a prominent color to soil. What is the color of soil in Konkan region? Red. Why? The color of soil in Konkan region is red. This soil has a lot of compounds of iron which are red in color. Hence, this soil is red in color. The color of the soil depends on texture like sandy, silt or clay, its organic substances and chemical substances like iron or lime. The color of soil indirectly tells us the properties of soil like fertility, drainage of water, capacity to hold water, etc. What are the various uses of soil? Soil helps in plant conservation. Soil helps plants to grow by providing support and nutrition. Repeated cultivation of the same crop reduces fertility of soil, and we say that land has become barren. Crops should be rotated so that fertility of soil is maintained. Soil helps in water conservation. You must have heard of slogan, "Plant more trees and save earth." Why do we need such slogans? Why should we plant more trees? Soil holds water. When trees are planted in the soil, the roots hold the soil together. This prevents washing off of the upper fertile layer of soil. Also, by building small bunds and lakes, water can be collected as soil can hold water. This water collected helps in increasing the groundwater level. This collected water can be used all year round. These methods adopted will help in making villages drought-free in India. Soil has the property of plasticity. Can you think of what material is used for making earthen pots, earthen lamps, idols, bricks, etc.? These earthen pots, earthen lamps, etc. are articles made from soil. The soil is taken and water is added to it. Then, on the wheel, potter gives the required shape for making earthen pots, lamps, etc. These pots are then dried to give them the permanent shape. This is possible because soil can be given any shape and this property of soil is called plasticity. What material is used for making crockery, bathroom tiles, laboratory apparatus, etc.? It is made up of China clay. This soil is called China clay as this type of soil is found in China. When this soil is heated, the soil acquires a glaze and hardness. So, we use this China clay for making crockery. China clay is also called kaolin. Which soil will you use for making Ganpati idols so that it becomes environment friendly? We can make idols of shadu soil. It is wheatish in color and is used for making statues and idols. Ganpati idols are made of the chemical calcium sulfate, that is, plaster of Paris. These idols of plaster of Paris do not dissolve in water, hence are not environment friendly. We should try and conserve our environment and reduce pollution. Which soil is used for making pots which are used for growing plants in homes or offices? This soil is reddish in color and is called terracotta soil. Which soil is used in cosmetics, mainly in face pack? Multani soil is used in cosmetics. It is extremely soft to touch.
Scientific analysis of soil can be done in order to determine various properties of soil, such as fertility, nutrients level, etc. We will show you how soil testing can be done in the next part of this video.
Can you tell why lychees are not produced in Maharashtra? Why are apples grown in the Himalayas? A particular crop requires a particular type of soil and climate for producing a proper profitable yield. Soil can be tested for finding out various ingredients present in it. Soil testing also tells us the deficiency of certain ingredients. It also tells us about the corrective measures to be taken to remove the deficiency. pH and electrical conductivity are the two tests that are performed to find the characteristics of soil. The Government of India has opened various soil testing centers where farmers can get their soil tested and follow the advice given by them to increase the produce. Causes of diminished soil fertility. 1. What pH of soil makes it fertile? Soil pH between 6.5 to 7.5 is said to be fertile soil. pH less than 6, that is acidic, or higher than 8, that is alkaline, makes the soil infertile. Presence of organic matter helps in returning the nutrients to the soil. Hence, low proportion of organic matter makes it infertile. What happens when there is a shortage of water or excess of water? In both cases, the farmer cannot take the produce. Shortage of water leads to drying of plants. Excess of water also leads to dying of plants. So, proper drainage of excess water is required for plants to grow. What happens when the same crop is cultivated again and again? Fertility of land decreases as the same type of nutrient is used up by the plant. So the quantity of yield will start decreasing. It is better to grow different varieties of crop. Example, leguminous plants help in returning the nutrients used by wheat crop. So after taking wheat crop, plant leguminous plants. This is called rotation of crops. Continuous use of saline water, chemical fertilizer and pesticides disturbs the soil texture and makes the land barren. That is, not suitable for growing plants. When is the World Soil Day celebrated? 5th December. Now think and answer the following questions. Question 1. Suppose you and your friend are on a trip to the moon. After landing on the moon, can you hear your friend talk? Why? Question 2. If you have a 10-floor building and you place the overhead tank at 3rd floor, can you now supply water to all the floors? Why? And question 3. In winter season, where the temperature falls below 0 degrees Celsius, the pipes carrying water burst. Why?